When's the last time there's been a new welding process in the market?
1940s,
yeah.
Right, when MIG welding came out?
Yeah.
For me, it's really exciting, right? I get to be at the tip of the spear for bringing a new process to market, but there's a learning curve. All right, let's see if we can't clean this up a little bit. So right here, we have our brand new laser demo trailer. So we're inside of our light tight laser safe booth, which is our trailer. This is where you're going to set your parameters. We really work off of our parameter chart here. So if you're welding, say, stainless steel with wire, you're welding 16 gauge, we're going to be on A2. Right? We're also able to go over here, do a tack weld autogenously. Right? It's basically got a spot timer in it. We're also able to move over and do laser cleaning as well. Power we're going to set in watts, right? So we're it's a 2 kilowatt machine, so we can go from 200 watts to 2,000 watts. Laser is a little bit different than our typical arc welding, right? Where there's no electrical current. So we're basically shooting light at metal through a magnifying glass, right? Instead of burning amps, we're melting metal. Here we have wobble frequency, so that is how fast that laser oscillates. The laser itself is a small focal spot. The spot is smaller than the diameter of your wire. So there's a little galvo mirror inside your torch, and it oscillates back and forth, left and right. So the frequency is how fast that's going to oscillate. Now, zero doesn't mean zero. Zero means nominal. Your wobble length, that's going to basically be your weld width. Again, it's zero doesn't mean zero. It means nominal. You can't have a negative length, but this is just how far off of nominal are we going. So this is how you're going to set the width of your weld. Frequency is more of a fine-tune adjustment, especially at high travel speeds. The main ones you're gonna play with to dial in your parameter sets first is gonna be power and your weld width, your wobble length.
Cool.
On the wire feeder side, standard what you'd expect from a Miller industrial wire feeder, right? So you've got your wire feed speed. Instead of your voltage, you're setting your retract distance, how far that wire retracts away from the weld pool when you terminate. Inside, these are all common parts. So exactly what you'd expect from a Miller wire feed system. The biggest difference here is that the unit is geared down, so the maximum feed rate is 80. So you've got two triggers here. The first one, first stage, is this long black one. You can hold this at any time. What you're going to hear is gas start to flow as the gas solenoid opens. It's also checking to make sure all of our interlocks are closed and met. We're going to have a solid green light, so we're good to go. As we come down here, we have to make continuity, right? We can't fire this laser unless it's making continuity. When we achieve it, we get a blinking green light on the top of the gun. Now, at this point, we can pull that second trigger, and we're able to both turn the wire feeder on and emit the laser. The wire is going to push you down the joint. So your entire job is just to keep the wire in the joint, hold your proper travel and work angles, and let the wire really set your travel speed for you. All right, we're going to keep our hands clear, our head away. We're not watching the puddle. We can't really do anything about it anyway. We're just letting the laser do the work.
We were all pretty excited to get into the trailer and try the laser welder for ourselves. We were told it would be fast. We were told it would be simple. We were told the weld quality would be better. The Miller OptX laser welder exceeded all of our expectations. We were blown away. Could this be the next revolution in welding technology? After trying it firsthand today, I don't think anyone here would be surprised if it were.
What'd you think?
Easy.
Very easy.
Really easy. Anybody can do it.
That was fantastic. Easy. Heath, you could even go weld right now.